Omajnanatimirandasya gnananjana shalakaya chakshur militam yena tasmai shri gurave namaha namo vishnu padaya krishna prishthaya bhutale shrimate bhakti vedanta swaminiti namine namaste sarasvate deve gauravani pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
So very important instruction is being given here by Kashyapa Muni to his wife Diti. Kashyapa Muni says that Lord Shiva is related to him as his younger brother. Because Diti's younger sister was given to Lord Shiva, Daksha's another daughter. So husband of one's sister is considered like a brother. So in that way, in social relationship, Lord Shiva happened to be the younger brother of Kashyapa. So what Kashyapa is saying is that don't take this relationship for granted. You are thinking Lord Shiva is related to me. He is related to us because my sister is married to him, so does not matter. Because I am related, nothing is going to happen. He will not consider this offense very seriously. Because when there is relationship, then many considerations may not be there. Just like we see in the example of Arjuna. Generally, Atatai should be killed. Aggressor has to be killed. But Arjuna is saying they are special Atatai because they are my relatives. Isn't it? So there is a difference. So Diti should not consider that Lord Shiva is related to us, so it does not matter. Let me take him for granted. Nothing is going to happen. Even if we break the rules of trying to enjoy in this sandhya time, it is not going to matter. He will excuse us probably because being related to us, he will not consider the rules very, very strictly. He will apply the rules not very strictly to us. So Diti may consider like this. So Prabhupada is explaining, Kashyapa is saying here in the translation, if you see, nayasya loke swajana parova. So don't think he is related. Actually, he has no one related to him. Nayasya loke swajanaha. Actually, this is a truth. For a pure devotee, there is no so-called swajana. Swajana is on the material platform. My people. These are all on material platform we consider. Just like Arjuna also was considering on material platform. He was saying, Swajanam hi katham hatva. If I kill my own people, how I can be happy? So Prabhupada explains, actually, on spiritual platform, Everyone is Swajana. Everyone is Swajana. Why? Because one sees that every living entity is related to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is the Supreme Father. We are all sons of that Supreme Lord. We are all His Amshas. So on spiritual platform, everyone is Swajana. On material platform, those who are related to this body, we consider them to be Swajana. Somebody born in the same family, somebody born in the same society, somebody born in the same nation, we consider them to be our own men, our own people. Others, we consider them to be distant, somebody else, strangers. Prabhupada says, actually, this mentality is not something very great. This Swajana mentality, this is there even in the animals. Few days back, we were hearing the example Prabhupada was giving, that even a dog has this concept of Swajana. Isn't it? You will find that in a street, in a place, you will find some few dogs, they will get together, some 5-6 dogs will be there, and they will all coexist peacefully there. 5-6 dogs, they consider themselves to be Swajana, my own dogs, my own people. Isn't it? And you'll find if there is another dog, some new dog enters into their area, all these 5-6 dogs, they will chase after him. That you are not Swajana, you are not my people, you are somebody else, you cannot come here, this is our territory. So Prabhupada says, this mentality is there even in the animal kingdom, even in the dog. And Prabhupada sometimes used to criticize, this immigration department is dog's department. Isn't it? Because they are thinking, only these many people who are in this boundary, they are our people. Other people cannot enter here. Isn't it? So, on spiritual platform, when one is elevated, when one is advanced, he understands that actually everyone is Swajana on spiritual platform, because every living entity is related to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So that's what it is said here. Na yasya loke Swajana parova. He has no one as his own Swajana and no one is disconnected from him. Because on spiritual platform he sees every living entity is connected to the Supreme Lord. So, Lord Shiva regards no one as his relative, yet there is no one who is not connected with him. Then, na ati adrataha na uta kaschit vigrahaha. He does not think, he does not make a partiality. Pure devotees are above partial behavior. When we are in conditioned life, we are partial to our people, and to other people we may not be favorable. Just like Prabhupada gives the example, Prabhupada says, the Supreme Lord and His pure devotees, they are like the sun. The sun has no discrimination. The sunlight is not thinking, this is a house of a chandala, this is a house of a brahmana. Brahmana is pure, so let me enter into the house of brahmana. And chandala is impure, so it is not required to enter in the house of chandala. No. So for the sunlight, for the sun, there is no such discrimination that I will only shine in the house of brahmana and not in the house of chandala. Similarly, for a pure devotee of the Lord, there is no such discrimination that he is favorite to me and he is not favorable, he is unfavorable. So, Prabhupada translates, he does not regard anyone as his favorable or somebody as abominable. That he is abominable, they are untouchable, abominable. Or he is thinking these people are favorable. So why Kashyapa is saying this is, do not think, Lord Shiva will think, you are my relative, so I will favor you. And somebody else I will punish, because they are abominable. So Lord Shiva, being a pure devotee of the Lord, has no such discrimination on material level. This discrimination exists on material level, not on spiritual level. So, in the purport, Prabhupada is making a very important point, which we will try to understand. Kashyapa informed his wife that just because Lord Shiva happened to be his brother-in-law, that should not encourage her in her offense towards him. So, just because Lord Shiva is connected, is related, and he happens to be brother-in-law, this should not breed the mentality that I can take everything for granted and let me break the rules, it does not matter. So this is very important point to understand. One should not disregard just because of familiarity. So this is a very important principle. Prabhupada explains that in material conception of life, familiarity breeds contempt. That is what is exactly happening to Diti, that she is thinking, I am wife of a great personality, Kashyapa Muni, so I can take him also for granted. And not only Kashyapa Muni, Lord Shiva, who may be roaming at this time and in the Sandhya time with all his ghostly people, all these personalities, you know, nothing is going to happen to me. That is, punishment is for others, because she has taken him also for granted. So Kashyapa is just telling her, don't take Lord Shiva for granted like this. So familiarity should not breed contempt. That is very important. Prabhupada explains one very important incident where actually we find that one breaks the law of maryada vyatikrama, when one becomes too familiar with his spiritual master also. So from this we can also learn, we should not become too familiar with our spiritual master on material conception, and even with deities of the Lord. Vedas say very clearly, one should not consider the deities of the Lord as some stone or some metal, and one should not consider the spiritual master as some ordinary living being. Isn't it? They have to be seen with spiritual conception. Even when we are seeing with material eyes. With material eyes, what do we see? We see metal. With spiritual conception, we can understand that actually metal is non-different from the Lord. For the Lord, there is no difference. He can be present in the metal. Fully he can be present in the metal, because that is his energy. So we have to see with spiritual conception. With material conception, we may see my body and my spiritual master's body is also same. Sometimes I am seeing my spiritual master is also having backache. He also wants massage. He is also getting old. He is also getting diseased. So with material vision, when we try to compare, then it will breed contempt. We will become offensive. Just like it is as good as saying, what is this? This is also metal. And that is also metal. So if this metal I can mishandle the deity form also. Anyway, that is also metal. And then what happens? When we take it for granted, when we take the deities for granted, we commit so many offenses. Actually, I have seen when I was the head of Pujari department in Bangalore, sometimes the Pujaris, actually Prabhupada explains, specifically Pujaris who are regularly doing deity service have to be very, very, very careful. If they take deities for granted, you know, then actually it is leading our way to hellish life if we commit offenses towards the deities. So sometimes I was seeing in Bangalore, sometimes the pujaris, how just to finish off sometimes their services to save some time, they would mishandle the deities as if deities are some kind of, you know, stone or some metal and it doesn't matter. Some duty is given to me, I have to finish this, that's all. You see, it's a lot of difference. The Lord has given us chance. Very mercifully, He has come in a form where we can dress Him. Will we be able to dress Lord Krishna in His original form, in Tribhangi form? That privilege is to Mother Yashoda. The Lord very mercifully, even to the conditioned soul, He comes in the form of a deity where we can dress Him, we can bathe Him, isn't it? We can decorate Him with proper consciousness. But if we take the deities for granted, so, you know, sometimes I saw that these pujaris who had no proper conception, they were taking the deities and, you know, practically dumping, and when they are doing abhishekam, dhaga dhaga dhaga, they are shaking the deities like anything. Just want to finish off as early as possible. Because if you do carefully, you have to do the abhishekam very nicely, very slowly, with feelings that yes, this is the Lord. He has given me the chance to massage His body, He has given me the chance to bathe His body. So it will take little time. So actually this mentality, Prabhupada says specifically, Prabhupada quotes that, specifically the pujaris and the personal servants of the spiritual master have to be very, very cautious. They should not become too familiar. The moment they become familiar with the spiritual master, they will start thinking ordinary man. Guru Mara Vidya. What is he? I know better than my guru. Isn't it? What did Chaitanya Mahaprabhu show? Even though he was the most learned scholar of his time, he was called Nimai Pandit. When he met his spiritual master, what he told to Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya and Prakashananda Saraswati? Guru More Murkh Dekhila. My spiritual master saw me as a fool. And I accept that I am a fool. So what am I doing? I am not trying to study Vedanta. He told me, don't study Vedanta. You cannot understand Vedanta. You simply chant the holy name of the Lord. And I am trying to follow that words of my spiritual master. I did not argue with him. So we have to remain a fool before our spiritual master and not try to see the spiritual master just on bodily platform. Rupa Goswami also explains that in Nectar of Instructions, that from external viewpoint, spiritual or a pure devotee's body, spiritual master's body may look like any of our body. Deformed, diseased. But he says actually, those who are intelligent, they understand. Just like the water of Ganges, It may look impure from outside sometimes, but still they will go and take bath. That actually, water of Ganges never becomes impure. Similarly, external viewpoint, my spiritual master body may have become fragile, it may have become aged or old, but still, it is not that spiritual master has become dependent on me. That one should understand very, very carefully. Prabhupada wrote one letter, very, very important letter, to one of his disciples, Kirtanananda. Actually, that's a fact. We find that how, even though Kirtanananda was one of the very intimate servant of Prabhupada, but he fell down and practically he was on the level of Mayavada. He had become at one point practically on the level of Mayavada. So Prabhupada wrote a letter to his disciples to make them to understand that how one should not become too familiar with his spiritual master and consider him to be some ordinary person. And that is what happened to Kirtanananda. He thought his spiritual master has become dependent on his service. Rather than thinking, this is an arrangement by the Lord, my spiritual master is diseased or old, it is an opportunity given by the Lord so that disciple can serve him personally and advance in spiritual life. We see that example in the life of Madhavendra Puris. Isn't it? How Ishwara Puri served his spiritual master. There were two disciples. One was Ramachandra Puri, one was Ishwara Puri. So Ishwara Puri, even when his spiritual master, when he was on the bed and he had to pass, you know, even clear his stomach in the bed. So Ishwara Puri with his own hand, he would pick up, he would clean that stool, taking it as an opportunity to serve his spiritual master. Whereas another disciple, Ramachandra Puri, when his spiritual master was lamenting for the Lord, that actually I am not able to meet that Supreme Lord, I am crying for him. Then Ramachandra Puri is preaching to his spiritual master. My dear spiritual master, you are supposed to be on the level of Brahman. On the level of Brahman, there should be no lamentation. Why are you lamenting? Na shochati, na kanchati. Isn't it? So he was seeing on material platform. So, Prabhupada wrote a very important letter, and I'll just read that. I am very concerned that due to your sincerity and service mood, you have improved in Krishna consciousness excellently. So Prabhupada is acknowledging sincere service mood. In that regard, only Prabhupada talks about one should not think when a spiritual master is giving service, one should not think spiritual master requires it or spiritual master is dependent on it. So Prabhupada is acknowledging sincere attitude of service. I am very concerned that due to your sincerity and service mood, you have improved in Krishna consciousness excellently. Whatever allocation of duty there may be, whatever allocation, if we try to execute such specific duty sincerely, that alone can make us much more advanced in Krishna consciousness. So whatever service is allocated, one should specifically try to execute those services properly. Prabhupada is saying that will make him more advanced in Krishna consciousness. In Bhagavad Gita, it is stated that for the fixed up devotee, there is one duty. For the fixed up devotee, there is vyavasayatmika buddhi. There is only one goal, there is only one duty. This duty is understood through the transparent medium, via medium of the spiritual master. So how to understand what is that my duty? That can be understood only through the spiritual master. It is better service to Krishna. You see, it's a better service. When we serve the spiritual master, it is a better service to Krishna. And spiritual master, a feeling of separation. We should serve the spiritual master in the feeling of separation. Actually, in that sense, we should always understand that even today, even when our spiritual master has wound off his leela, his bhome leela, he is not physically present with us in that sense. But still, Prabhupada is saying here, we can serve him in the feeling of separation. And actually Prabhupada is saying, sometimes there is a risk in the matter of direct service. Better to serve the spiritual master in the feeling of separation. Because sometimes there is a risk. If we have material mentality, contaminated mentality, if we take direct service to the body of the spiritual master, actually we will create so many offenses. So Prabhupada is saying it is better to serve the spiritual master in the feeling of separation. For example, Prabhupada is giving the example. Kirtanananda was giving me direct service by massaging, cooking for me and so many other things. But later on, by dictation of Maya, he became puffed up. So much so that he thought his spiritual master a common man. And what did he think? And was existing only on account of his service. So he's thinking, not only my spiritual master is a common man, he's surviving because of my service to him. He has become dependent on me. The disciple is thinking my spiritual master has become dependent on me. Rather than thinking it is an opportunity given by the spiritual master to his disciple to advance in Krishna consciousness. This mentality at once pushed him down. Of course, those who are sincere devotees, they take direct service as an opportunity. But those who are sincere, when direct service like this is available, they take it as an opportunity to advance. But the illusory energy is so strong that it acts on this doctrine of familiarity breeds contempt. Kirtanananda was thinking, I was existing on his service. Instead of realizing, I was giving him opportunity to do me some service. Actually, spiritual master is giving us service. He is giving us an opportunity to advance. Because Krishna is saying in Bhagavatam, Acharya Mam Vijaniya. Don't think Acharya to be separate from me. Just like we have the mentality to serve the Supreme Lord, similarly we should have the mentality to serve the Acharya, the spiritual master. So actually, it is very important for the pujaris specifically. We may not have the direct service of Prabhupada because he is physically not present in that sense. But deities we are serving. So those who are doing the service of the pujaris, sometimes we take the deities for granted. We should do the service of the deities with utmost respect, utmost reverence. In fact, Prabhupada used to say that the service we are doing is in Aishwarya Bhav. We should not be trying to think I am doing service in spontaneous Bhav. That is for very advanced devotees in Vrindavan. Just like when Mother Yashoda is dressing Krishna, she may chastise Krishna at the same time. Isn't it? Because that is the relation she has got. We cannot think. We have to serve the Lord, just like Lakshmi cannot think. She can only be thinking of serving the feet of the Lord. She cannot be thinking of putting her hand on the shoulder of Lord Vishnu. We have never seen. We don't see that. Whereas Radharani we see. Krishna, Radharani is putting her hand on the shoulder of Krishna. Lakshmi you don't see. Lakshmi is always at the feet of the Lord, serving the feet of the Lord. So we have to serve the Supreme Lord in that reverence. So, pujaris have to be very careful when you are giving abhishekam to the Lord with that mentality, that respect we have to do, that here is an opportunity for me to serve the Lord. Not that this is some metal, somehow or other, fatafat I should finish and do some other service. Arey, what is that other service? One service is given to you that is meant for making you advanced in spiritual life. Saving time for some other service, saving time for japa in this service time, it is a horrible mentality. One should understand that. Japa time is meant for japa. When you go for japa, you chant. This is secret of success in Krishna consciousness is what you are doing, be absorbed in that. At the time of service, don't think about japa. At the time of japa, don't think about service. When you are serving the Lord, don't think about japa. Don't think about so many other things. At that time, be absorbed completely in serving the Lord. How best I can do the abhishekam? How best I can do serving the Lord? How best I can decorate the Lord? How best I can do the shingara for the Lord? How best I can dress up the Lord? That should be the mentality when we are doing the service of the Lord. We should be aware. Just like when a great personality is present with us, will we talk nonsense in front of him? Suppose Madhu Pandit Prabhu comes or some senior devotee comes. We are very aware. We don't talk frivolously. Isn't it? Similarly, we should be aware. He is not some ordinary person. He is VVVV, thousand lakhs time VVIP. The deities of the Lord, when they are present, we should think. That veneration we should have. Isn't it? I was giving the example in one of the classes. Once I went to one temple, I think somewhere in Dwaraka. I exactly don't remember. So there, the pujari I saw that how even while giving the rest to the deities, he was asking the permission. My dear Lord, can I remove your flute? So then he's removing the flute, he's removing the, you know, different things. So they treat even with, so even when we are doing, even though we may be offering mantras, everything, we should understand the meaning of that. When we are chanting the Shayana mantra, what are we saying? We are requesting the Lord, my dear Lord, now please go to the sleep. Isn't it? So we have to do with lot of veneration. And sometimes I see devotees, they become angry on each other in front of the deities. These are all very, very risky. Naam aparad, there are only 10 offenses. Vigraha aparad, deity aparad, there are 64. Seva aparad, they are called. So while serving the deities, there are so many rules and regulations. So devotees talking loudly, frivolously. Like once I heard one devotee who was assistant pujari, he was surprised to see that he is, you know, second initiated devotee. Some song was going on here in this, you know, we have an ashram here, Dattatreya song, and then they are commenting and laughing at each other, commenting on the song inside the altar. These are all very, very frivolous acts we do. So we have to be very cautious that we don't do these kinds of seva prayas. So Prabhupada is saying this, be very careful, familiarity should not breed contempt. So don't become too familiar with deities, don't become too familiar with the spiritual master. Then what will happen? Only offenses will start. So we should always maintain a distance from the deities. We should always maintain distance from the spiritual master and serve him with that veneration. So here we are seeing the example that how Diti had become too familiar with the husband and too familiar thinking that Lord Shiva is related and so nothing is going to happen. Even if I break some rules and regulation, he will be partial, nothing is going to happen. And then offenses starts. That is how. and we see the result of these offenses, what is going to happen? That she will have to bear with demoniac children in the future. So this is one. Another one more example Prabhupada gives about, and after that we will stop. Prabhupada says that once we know the story of Indra. So Indra, with all of the demigods, he was present in the assembly in his, you know, in his kingdom. So in that assembly, he was being glorified by some devatas, all those things. And then he was sitting with his wife, Sachi. So in that assembly, the spiritual master of the demigod, Brihaspati, entered. So he did not even take any cognizance of his spiritual master. He did not get up from his seat. He did not offer obeisances. Because, Prabhupada explains, Indra thought, my spiritual master, anytime he comes, keeps on coming. So many times he comes. How many times I should get up? How many times I should offer obeisances? Isn't? This is called familiarity. So similarly, when we enter the temple, we should not think, every time I have to enter the temple, why should I offer my obeisances? Isn't it? So we should not breed that principle of familiarity. And then the result of this was that when his spiritual master was dissatisfied, he immediately left the assembly. And because of that, all his opulence was lost. All his opulence was lost. Devatas were conquered by the demons. Then finally, after all these things happened, then Indra realized his mistake. That all this is because of my offenses to my spiritual master. Then he went to Brahma for a solution. Then all the devatas went together to, you know, beg pardon. And then they went for a solution to Brahma. So this is another example Prabhupada gives about how one should not become too familiar with his spiritual master. So example is given in the Vedas, that Prabhupada used to quote this example, that one who is living in Calcutta where Ganges is flowing. So he is thinking, even though Ganges is flowing, yet still he is going to Haridwar for the same Ganges. He is thinking, this is not Ganges, this is ordinary water here. So he is going to some other place. Actually the same, it is the same river Ganga, which is coming in Haridwar also and which is coming in Calcutta also. So one should not breed that, you know, familiarity with superior personalities and then start offending. Then he is not able to receive any kind of instructions from them. So the same thing happened, and we see the example in the form of the theory. Some few more points were there, but I think it's already time. We'll cover in some other class. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.